In this video, we're going to take a look at the ultimate list of AMC muscle cars. Let's dive in. The AMC AMX is a two-seater sports car built from 1968 to 1970 to compete as a budget alternative to the Chevrolet Corvette and was a lighter, shorter, and more compressed Javelin. The highest performance engine was the 390 V8 in 1970, with 10.2 compression, 325 horsepower, and 420 pound-feet of torque. While impressive on paper, it wasn't one of the top 10 fastest muscle cars of 1970, and almost came in dead last out of 29 tested, barely beating the Monte Carlo SS 454 and Rally 350. Three vibrant paint color options known as Big Bad were offered in 1969 and 1970, including orange, green, and blue. This naming had nothing to do with any performance modifications. In the 70 issue of Superstock and Drag Illustrated magazine, a 1970 AMC AMX ran a 14.46 second quarter mile, traveling 95.6 miles per hour. While 1970 ended the standalone two-seater body style, the AMX continued in the four-seat Javelin platform from 1971 to 1974. In 1971, the AMX transplanted to the Javelin hardtop body style to compete against the Ford Mustang, Mercury Cougar, and Chevrolet Camaro. The AMX was AMC's first true pony car that offered sleek styling, comfortable seating for four, and a big block. The 401 cubic inch V8 replaced the 390 V8 and offered 9.5:1 compression, 330 horsepower, and 430 pound-feet of torque. A more economical 360 V8 was also an option. In the 1971 issue of Sport Car Graphic magazine, a 71 AMX 401 ran the quarter mile in 14.3 seconds, traveling 98.8 miles per hour, making it the 12th fastest muscle car of 1971. American Motors never produced a high-horsepower V8 Gremlin. The largest engine option was a 304 V8 from the factory. However, that didn't stop one AMC dealer from developing one. Located in Mesa, Arizona, Randall AMC was given the green light by AMC to produce 401 cubic inch V8 powered Gremlins. These dealer modified Gremlin X sold for $2,995 from 1972 to 1974. Randall AMC had a long racing history, and they put that knowledge to work on 401 XR. They added a larger cam, high-rise manifold, higher CFM carburetor, heavy-duty driveline, and other performance-oriented modifications to the mix. Known as the Randall 401 XR, they all started life as a 304 V8 powered Gremlin X. Once converted, the 401 XR produced a 13.9 second quarter mile run, traveling at 103 miles per hour. While the Gremlin X sold more than 671,000 units in its model run, only 22 Randall 401 XRs were produced. The 1974 AMC Gremlin Randall 401 XR featured in the photo is the last one produced. It sold for $26,550 in 2018, with a few additional modifications. It ran a 12.22 second quarter mile, traveling 115.07 miles per hour. The Rebel Machine was a one-year-only high-performance muscle car model option offered on the 1970 AMC Rebel and was one of the most radical muscle cars ever produced. The first 1,000 1970 AMC Rebel machines produced were painted the patriotic red, white, and blue color scheme. The remaining 1,326 were available in any standard Rebel paint color. A 390 V8 powered all 2,326 with 10.2 compression, 340 horsepower, and 427 pound-feet of torque. In addition, the machine option included a blacked-out grille, 15-inch wheels, 8,000 revolutions per minute hood tack, and functional hood scoops. In the January 1970 issue of Superstock and Drag Illustrated magazine, a Rebel machine ran a best of 14.40 seconds in the quarter mile, traveling 100.6 miles per hour. The 1971 AMC Matador machine was the second time AMX offered the machine and picked up where the 1970 AMC Rebel machine left off. While the machine nameplate continued in 1971, the patriotic red, white, and blue paint scheme and 390 V8 from 1970 didn't. Neither did the functional Ram air induction hood. The 71 Matador machine wasn't a standalone model and became a bundle option called the Machine Go package. This package included 15-inch wheels, power disc brakes, dual exhaust, and a heavy-duty handling package. A 1971 Matador machine could be ordered in any standard Matador paint color and could be optioned with either a 360 or a 401 V8. The 401 produced 330 horsepower and 430 pound-feet of torque. Unfortunately, the 1971 Matador machine production run was cut short at approximately 50 vehicles. No official production records exist. The 1969 AMC Hurst SC Rambler was a $2,998 budget performance muscle car that was produced for NHRA stock class drag racing. It, too, was a one-year-only model. The SC Rambler option included a 390 V8 with 315 horsepower, four-barrel carburetor, four-speed close-ratio manual transmission, Hurst shifter and linkage, Suntac, dual exhaust, functional hood scoops, twin grip differential, power front disc brakes, handling package, heavy-duty cooling system, hood pings, teardrop racing mirrors, and a custom grille. Two paint color options were offered, A Scheme and B Scheme. The A Scheme started with a white base with an oversized red side body stripe and a blue stripe across the vehicle's top. The B Scheme also started with a white base but with two side body stripes, one red and one blue, running the length of the lower panels. In the May 1969 issue of Road Test magazine, a 69 Hurst SC Rambler ran a best of 14.14 seconds in the quarter mile, traveling at 100.9 miles per hour. While American Motors had planned a 500-vehicle production run, they produced 1,502 when it was all said and done. The iconic 1969 AMC Hurst SS AMX was produced, specially modified, and prepared for NHRA and AHRA drag racing competitions. According to the window sticker, it was intended for use in supervised acceleration trials and is not intended for highway or general passenger use. Originally, only 50 Hurst SS AMX were slated for production. However, thanks to Sunset AMC, two additional units were accommodated. Car number 52 was recently found in 2019. The suggested retail price of a 1969 AMC Hurst SS AMX was a hefty $5,994, which translates into $41,438 in today's dollars. Because the Hurst SS AMX was solely intended for drag racing, it was sold as is and did not include the standard 12 months or 12,000-mile vehicle warranty, or the 5 years 50,000-mile powertrain warranty. The 52 white 390 cubic inch V8 equipped 1969 AMC AMX were sent from Kenosha, Wisconsin to Hurst Performance Products in Ferndale, Michigan for conversion. The conversion included a smattering of high performance modifications, including a specially modified 390 V8 engine with 12.3:1 compression, Edelbrock aluminum dual cross ram intake manifold, twin Holley 650 carburetors, functional cold air metal hood scoop, Doug's super stock exhaust headers and exhaust system, 4.44 rear gear ratio, twin grip differential, Mallory ignition, Hurst remote shifter, Borg Warner close ratio 4-speed transmission, heavy duty competition super stock clutch, Lakewood hydroformed explosion proof bell housing, heavy duty radiator, trunk mounted battery, plus a few other goodies. Even the rear wheel wells were modified to accommodate racing slicks. No options were offered on the SS AMX. However, two paint schemes were available, including the iconic red, white, and blue, or a solid frost white version for those who wanted to customize their own paint scheme. According to AMC, a 1969 Hurst SS AMX ran a quarter mile time of 11.08 seconds, traveling at 127.1 miles per hour. Of the 52 built, roughly 40 have been accounted for in the SS AMX registry. Like many other AMC muscle cars, this was also a one-year-only option. The 1971 AMC Hornet SC-360 was a limited production run AMC muscle car produced from August 1970 until February 1971. The SC360 was a slam dunk idea given that the Hornet platform could already accommodate a 304 V8 engine, which was the same externally as the 360. With a few stripes, a twin grip differential, and a hood scoop, the 1971 Hornet SC was born. The retail price for this compact rocket was value priced at $2,663. The four-barrel 360 cubic inch V8 with dual exhaust produced 285 horsepower, while the two-barrel option with single exhaust generated 245 horsepower. In the December 1970 issue of Hot Rod magazine, a 71 Hornet SC 360 ran a quarter mile at 14.8 seconds, traveling 94.63 miles per hour. In total, 578 Hornet SC 360 were equipped with a four-barrel carburetor and 206 with a two-barrel. All 784 Super Coupe 360 were sedans. The 1970 AMC Trans Am Javelin SST was a one-year-only homologation special to compete in SCCA Trans Am racing clad. With a factory price of $3,995, it is no wonder that AMC only produced 100 Trans Am Javelins of the 19,714 Javelin units built in 1970. In addition to the tri-colored paint job, the Trans Am Javelin came equipped with a 390 V8 engine with 325 horsepower and 420 pound-feet of torque, go package, heavy-duty cooling system, dual exhaust, Ram induction system, BorgWarner T10 four-speed manual transmission, and Hurst competition shifter. The 1970 Mark Donohue Javelin was another homologation special to help satisfy the 2,500-unit requirement for a new specialized ducktail rear deck lid spoiler and functional Ram air system to be allowed for use on the SSCA racing circuit. Every Mark Donohue Javelin was equipped with the Go package that included front disc brakes, heavy-duty suspension, upgraded cooling system, dual exhaust, twin grip rear end, 140 miles per hour speedo, and a four-speed manual transmission as standard with a three-speed automatic transmission offered as an option. The Go package was a term used to describe a performance package offered on the AMX, Javelin, Hornet SC 360, and the Matador machine. Contents of the package varied from 1968 to 1974 and from model to model. Mark Donohue Javelins were available in any standard Javelin color, including Big Bad Orange, Blue, and Green. AMC produced 2,501 Mark Donohue Javelins, beating the 2,500 homologation requirements by one unit.